Good morning, students. We are going to continue chapter 6 of NCERT, that is tissues. Students, we have already done the definition of tissues, in which we have learned what actually tissue comprises of, and started with the topic of plant tissues, in which we have covered meristematic tissues. Now it's time to learn about permanent tissues. So let's begin. Topics which are being covered in this tutorial are, first of all, we need to discuss permanent tissue, its characteristic features, and its basic two types, that is simple and complex. Students, the thing first come to your mind that meristematic tissues are going to divide repeatedly and form newer and newer cells. What happened to those cells? What is the fate of these newly formed cells? These newly formed cells undergone for the process of cell differentiation and ultimately converted into the permanent tissue, either simple or complex. So meristematic tissues have the ability to divide repeatedly, but permanent tissue do not have such capacity. They lose their ability to divide repeatedly, but they attain the capacity to perform a specialized function for the plant body. So, what is differentiation? It is a process of changing shape, size, and function of the meristematic tissue and its conversion into the permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue divide repeatedly. However, permanent tissue loses their ability to divide, but they are going to perform specialized function. Okay? So, now comes to the definition. Permanent tissues are formed from meristematic tissue, right? Loses their ability to divide and going to perform a specialized function via the process of differentiation. They do not divide at all and having permanent shape and size. They can be living or non-living, have thick or thin cell wall, but they have a specialized structure, that is vacuole. Why do they process vacuole? Because they are going to perform specialized functions, so they require full-fledged vacuole. Now it's time to discuss the difference between meristematic tissue and permanent tissue. Meristematic tissue divide repeatedly throughout their life. They are going to undergo division again and again, going to form newer and newer cells. Permanent tissues going to lose their ability to divide and going to perform specialized function. As you know, meristematic tissues are located at specialized location like apical, lateral, and intercalary. Permanent tissue are distributed throughout the plant body. Whatever you see, stem, leaves, root, you will find permanent tissue there. Okay, cells of the meristematic tissue are very active, having dense cytoplasm, thin wall, have prominent nucleus, going to lack almost vacuole because their sole motor is to divide, so nucleus is going to help them. But there is no role of the vacuole. But in permanent tissue, we will find a full-fledged vacuole over there, vary in shape and size. Their cell wall may be thick or thin, as we have discussed earlier. Simple permanent tissue can be of three types. As you know, they have same origin, structure, and function, but categorized into the three main parts, that is parenchyma, colenchyma, and sclerenchyma. First type is parenchyma. That is the most common type, and you can see these beautiful structures. These are the parenchyma cells throughout the plant body, either stem, root, leaf. You will find parenchyma over there. The cell wall is made up of cellulose. The cytoplasm is quite dense, and you can observe these white inside structures. These are the vacuole, and the small peripheral nucleus you can easily recognize here also. And they can be rounded, oval, polygonal, spherical in shape. And one most important thing you are going to observe, lots of intercellular spaces, the gap between adjacent cells. Okay, these are white portion outside the cells. You can see these are actually the intercellular spaces. Here also you can see these white spaces are the intercellular spaces, and parenchyma cells have big central vacuole and peripheral nucleus. Here also you can see various type of shapes of the parenchyma cells. Here it is polygonal, okay, it can be spherical here also, and you can see the intercellular spaces. The cell wall is quite thin and made up of cellulose, okay, but the cytoplasm is quite dense, having small peripherally located nucleus. Location, where they are exactly located, they can be present at the outer section of the stem or root, that is referred as cortex region, and the innermost section of the root and stem, that is pith section. It is found as a component of xylem and phloem. We are going to study later in this section only. They are important integral component of xylem and phloem. Okay. Now, what functions they actually perform? They are going to store the food material in terms of the starch, that is the reserve food material, and referred as storage parenchyma. And next thing, parenchymatous cells can have large air cavity, that is referred as arenchyma. When lots of air cavity are being present inside that of the parenchyma, that is referred as arenchyma. They have the ability to float. Here you can see the stem of the lily. You can observe large intercellular spaces and air cavities. These are actually the arenchyma. Okay. When the parenchyma cells contain chloroplast, that is referred as chlorenchyma. Okay. They act as a packaging tissue, filling the spaces between other tissue. They also maintain shape and firmness of the plant body. The cells stored excretory products in the form of gum and raisins. Here you can see the arenchyma. Lots of air cavities are being present, which ultimately provide the ability to the aquatic plants to float over the water surface. And here you can see chlorenchyma cells having lots of chloroplast, that is going to perform photosynthesis. Okay. Now comes to the collenchyma. When the word comes to the collenchyma in your mind, always remember corner wall thickening. Corner wall thickening, when the cells are going to have corner wall thickening, that's red colors spaces, or you can find the structure over there, that is actually the corner wall thickening, made up of what kind of a structure? That is of cellulose. Okay. That is the cellulose wall thickening, corner wall thickening. Okay. They are referred as collenchyma. The shape can be oval, polygonal, whatever kind of shape, but they have centrally located vacuole and going to have tightly packed together, and intercellular spaces are almost nil or absent. The cell wall are quite irregular because of a cornered wall thickening. Okay. Of what kind of material? That is of cellulose. This is the transverse section, and here you can see in the longitudinal section you can observe the red color structure. Red color structure actually the cellulose cornered wall thickening. Always remember this word. Now where actually the collenchyma located? That is on the below the epidermis of the stem, petiole or leaves. They are going to provide lots of tensile strength. What is tensile strength? That is flexibility along with firmness or strongness. That is referred as tensile strength. And if the flexibility is there, so that plant can withstand with the high wind velocity. Okay. Otherwise, the plant can be detached from the surface. Because of collenchyma cells, plant have some sort of flexibility. They are going to provide mechanical support as well as elasticity, as we have discussed. Okay. Now come to the sphenchymatosis. Sphenchymatosis, always remember, they have thick, thick wall deposition made up of lignin. Okay, lignin is that type of component that is proteinaceous along with some sort of glucose molecule. And whenever this thickening is there inside that of the cell, that led to the death of the cell. So these cells are basically dead cells at maturity and going to lack all sort of cytoplasm. As they are dead, they do not require any sort of cytoplasm. Okay, so sphenchymatous cells, you can see all cell wall is being thickened with the lignin. Okay, and these cells are completely dead. This is the transverse section and this is the longitudinal section. You can see narrow lumen. Lumen means the hollow cavity inside the cell, and this is the lignified cell wall, you can see. And here some gaps are being left where lignin is totally absent. These are referred as pit. Pit means gap where the lignin is completely absent. Okay, here you can see the thick cells. The thickening is because of lignin and they do not have any sort of cytoplasm. Okay, sclerenchymatous cells are basically of two categories, fibers and sclerite. Always remember, fibers like thread kind of a structure and having a spindle shape, pointed, and they are found around the vascular tissues of the plant. And have you ever seen the husk of the coconut? Okay, the hairs of the coconut, that is actually made up of sclerenchymatous cells. Sclerite are referred as stone cells. The crunchiness of chiku or sapota or pear, that is because of what? That is because of stone cells. They are thick-walled, hard, strongly lignified. And you can see fibers as elongated structures. Sclerites are actually the star-shaped cells. Okay? They are located around the vascular bundle, outermost covering of the nerves, seeds and fruits. They are going to provide all sort of mechanical strength to the plant. Grittiness of the fruits is because of the sclerites. Okay, and going to protect the plant from any sort of stress, water stress or any sort of photosynthetic stress, whatever kind of stress, that is going to be tolerated with the help of sclerenchyma. Okay, you can see fibers. This is the TS section and here you can see as a round structure, but these are actually the elongated structure. These star shaped cells are actually sclerites. Okay, that provides the grittiness or the crunchiness of the foods like chiku. Okay, that is these are actually sclerites, star shaped cells. This is the actual visualization of the sclerite. Okay, protective tissue. Now come to the another type of permanent tissue. These are protective in nature. And these are outermost layer around the various plant part like root, stem and fruits, leaves. They are going to protect the plant body from surrounding harsh climate or pathogen. They are basically of two types, epidermis and cork. Epidermis, as the word suggests, above layer. Epi means above and dermis means layer. And cork is the centralized tissue of a stem or root. Cells are closely packed with each other and intercellular spaces are completely absent or nil. Okay, now come to the epidermis. Epidermis is the outer layer of the plant, example leaf, flower, stem and root. They have the thick cuticle or the waxy coating over the surface. You have observed this cuticle layer over the surface of the leaf. The shininess of the leaf is because of the cutin or the waxy deposition over the leaf surface. Epidermal cells are quite elongated and flattened. Intercellular spaces, as you know, are completely absent. They provide protection to the plant surface from any sort of desiccation, that is abrasion, and any sort of infection also by pathogens like fungus, bacteria, any sort of pathogen. Stomatal pores can be seen over the surface of leaves as well as young stem. When the stem is quite green and the plant is quite young, you can observe stomatal pores over there. You can see these are the beautiful V-shaped structure, and this centralized white color section is stomatal pole. Now come to the function of stomata. You are quite aware stomata are going to play a vital role in gases exchange. Gases exchange is the taking of CO2 for the process of photosynthesis, and O2 is not being required by the plant. That is also going out of the plant body by the stomatal cells. Okay. Transpiration. Transpiration is actually the loss of water from the surface of the leaf. That is done with the help of stomata. Okay. Cork. When the stem and roots are going to be older, the tissues become dead again and again. And that is because of sebrinin deposit. Sebrinin is a waxy, thick waxy coating which prevents loss of water and totally impervious to any sort of gases. No gas can cross this barrier actually. Okay. Intercellular spaces are totally absent. It is going to have several layers. Okay, these are actually the protective cells. Now comes to the complex permanent tissue. Complex, when the term complex comes to your mind, always remember they are going to have a different shape, structure, and the most common thing is they have various type of cells altogether. Complex means they comprises of various type of cells. Okay, so basically they are made up of more than one type of cells having same origin and going to perform particular function. They work in coordination actually. Okay, complex tissues are of two types, xylem and phloem. They are referred as vascular tissue or conducting tissue. Now comes to the xylem. Xylem, as you know, they are going to conduct the water from the root along with the minerals to the various plant part. They are going to provide mechanical strength to the plant part. They are basically are of four types, that is tracheids, vessels, xylem parenchyma and xylem fibers. Out of four types, only xylem parenchyma is the living one, rest are the dead one. Tracheids, these are dead, as I have told you before. Cell lumen is quite wide. You can see the wideness of the lumen here. And it becomes taper, pointed towards the end. Here also you can see pointed ends. Vessels are the long dead tubes stacked one over the another, forming continuous pipe-like structure. Okay, they are going to have lignified cell wall. When the lignin deposition is there in the cell, then the cell is the dead one. Always remember. They are going to have pits. Pits are the gaps. Here you can see the gaps, the dark green structures. These are actually the pits. Now comes to the xylem parenchyma. Xylem parenchyma is the living one. And parenchymal cells, you know the characteristic feature. They are going to have large intercellular spaces, thin cell wall, going to store food, and helps in the lateral conduction. Lateral means this type of conduction, sideways conduction, okay, of minerals. Now comes to the fibers. These are actually sclerenchymas, having thick wall, having narrow lumen. You can see these are going to have narrow lumen. The lumen, the central part is quite narrow, having tapering end. Cell walls are quite lignified, going to provide mechanical strength. As you know, they are the dead cells, are going to provide mechanical strength. Okay, so that's all for today. Thank you.